Asyraf Zulhakim here, coming to you live from the scene of a highly classified lab experiment regarding energy formation. Sources say that this experiment is somewhat very common, yet very important in living organisms. Let's have a closer look, shall we? This process is called glycolysis. Glycolysis is the first step in the breakdown of glucose to extract energy for cellular metabolism. Nearly all living organisms carry out glycolysis as part of their metabolism. The process does not use oxygen and is therefore anaerobic. Glycolysis takes place in the cytoplasm of both prokaryotic and eukaryotic cells. This process consists of 10 steps divided into two distinct halves. The first half of glycolysis is also known as the energy requiring steps, where ATPs are used in the process. The second half of glycolysis, also known as the energy-releasing steps, extracts energy from the molecules and stores it in the form of ATP and NADH. In the first half, the first step in glycolysis is catalyzed by hexokinase, an enzyme with broad specificity that catalyzes the phosphorylation of 6 carbon sugars. Hexokinase phosphorylates glucose using ATP as the source of the phosphate, producing glucose-6-phosphate, which is a more reactive form of glucose. In the second step of glycolysis, an isomerase converts glucose-6-phosphate into one of its isomers, which is fructose-6-phosphate. This change from phosphoglucose to phosphofructose allows the eventual split of the sugar into 2-3 carbon molecules. The third step is the phosphorylation of fructose-6-phosphate, catalyzed by the enzyme phosphofructokinase. A second ATP molecule donates a high-energy phosphate to fructose-6-phosphate, producing fructose-1,6-biphosphate. The newly added high-energy phosphates further destabilize fructose-1,6-biphosphate. The fourth step in glycolysis employs an enzyme, aldolase, to cleave 1,6-biphosphate into 2,3 carbon isomers, which is dihydroxyacetone phosphate and glyceraldehyde-3-phosphate. At the end product of the fourth step, there is now 2,3 carbon isomers, which is dihydroxyacetone phosphate and glyceraldehyde-3-phosphate. In the fifth step, an isomerase transforms the dihydroxyacetone phosphate into its isomer, which is glyceraldehyde-3-phosphate. Thus, the pathway will continue with two molecules of a single isomer. At this point in the pathway, there is a net investment of energy from two ATP molecules in the breakdown of one glucose molecule. The sixth step in glycolysis oxidizes the sugar glyceraldehyde-3-phosphate by the enzyme GLAP hydrogenase, extracting high-energy electrons which are picked up by the electron carrier NAD+, producing NADH. The sugar is then phosphorylated by the addition of a second phosphate group, producing 1,3-biphosphoglycerate. In the seventh step, catalyzed by phosphoglycerate kinase, which is an enzyme named for the reverse reaction, 1,3-biphosphoglycerate donates a high-energy phosphate to ADP, forming one molecule of ATP. A carbonyl group on the 1,3-biphosphoglycerate is oxidized to a carboxyl group, and 3-phosphoglycerate is formed. In the 8th step, the remaining phosphate group in 3-phosphoglycerate moves from the 3rd carbon to the 2nd carbon, producing 2-phosphoglycerate, which is an isomer of 3-phosphoglycerate. The enzyme catalyzing this step is a mutase. Enolase catalyzes the 9th step. This enzyme causes 2-phosphoglycerate to lose water from its structure. This is a dehydration reaction, resulting in the formation of a double bond that increases the potential energy in the remaining phosphate bond and produces phosphoenol pyruvate, PEP. The last step in glycolysis is catalyzed by the enzyme pyruvate kinase and results in the production of a second ATP molecule by substrate level phosphorylation and the compound pyruvate. Finally, the end product of glycolysis is pyruvate, 2 ATPs, and 2 NADH.